Have you ever wanted to start your own microgreens? It's probably a lot easier than you expect. You'll need to get a small tray. I used a 10-inch tray that I got at a local hardware store for about $1.50. You can even use something that you have laying around already. Next, you're going to need some seed-starting soil. You can use just regular potting soil, but if you find one that says seed starting, it's probably got some nutrients and a good mix of vermiculite and peat moss in it that will keep it from being too dirty and will help it hold moisture. Now you're going to need to soak the soil. Just add some water until it's floating around on top and leave it for about 15 minutes to let it get soaked in. You can stir the soil a little if you want to help hasten that process. Next, you'll have to select your seeds. This will be your biggest challenge. Now, you can find them off Amazon and eBay, but you may be lucky and have a local health food store that carries them, or even a hardware store like Home Depot. I have selected to use broccoli seeds for this batch. They have a nice tangy taste and they're easy to grow. You can also find things like sandwich mix or radish or mustard seeds. You can also use sunflower seeds and adzuki beans. So there's a lot of variety out there. Sunflower seeds will be thick and add crunch to salads and sandwiches, where the little seeds like broccoli seeds and mustard seeds will add taste and are a nice garnish to add to a salad or a sandwich, or just on the side of your plate. Before adding your seeds, pat the soil down. Now, add your seeds and spread them evenly over the entire soil. Spray your seeds with plain water to keep them moist. Now, put the seeds by a window and cover them. I've just used some thick paper that I've cut out to fit around the container. In just a couple of days, you're going to get sprouts. And then you can take the cover off and leave it. Every day or two now, you want to spray the sprouts just to keep the soil moist. And they'll be ready to eat in between 7 and 10 days. You can be the judge by how long they get. The easiest way to harvest them is just by using some scissors to cut them down after they're about 2 or 3 inches tall. Anyway, I hope you've enjoyed this video and it's helpful, and we'll check in with you again soon. Take care.